Auto Park is coming for Tesla Model Y and Model 3. We have news that there is going to be a new Auto Park feature coming for the Tesla Model Y and Model 3. This will allow one to easily park, especially during periods of dense traffic, friends. However, there are some very profound implications of a Tesla being able to auto park that we will talk about this here and mention as well. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Hari. I'm from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please join our community, subscribe to our channel, and give us thumbs up for this report, please, if you find it helpful, and we would greatly appreciate it if you would share in social media. Jeremy Johnson from Torque News Tesla reporting team has the details, saying Tesla's latest auto park feature is set to use cameras as well as ultrasonic sensors. According to a long thread on Reddit, I will have the description, the link in this description. We can see the time in action in the about in the video that I will have the link. Let's see what people have to say about this. By the way, like I said, I will have the link of that video from Twitter in this video. Comments from Reddit users. There was a comment from a Reddit user who thought it would be awesome if the auto park showed all available spots in view and allowed the driver to pick. The current visualization doesn't make it clear which spot the auto park is suggested or going for. Friends, another user says it is a critical part of the advanced summon feature to have the car go park itself. It will definitely come someday. This is a huge step close to that promise. What are your thoughts? Let me know, friends. So I would add, says Jeremy, that the auto park feature is even more important than this. When robotaxis start coming into operation, a Tesla vehicle will need to know how to go park in a stall and wait either for charging or for the owner to come get the vehicle for his or her own use or to do maintenance on it. The car will need to be able to follow lines and park. Another user stated that most auto park systems can only work between other cars with pure ultrasonic detection of open spaces. Now, and that being able to just use lines and vision is a huge step forward and will really help with curbs. Do you think this is a huge step forward or not really a big deal? Let me know, friends, in the comment section below. So other Tesla owners talked about how they could never get their car using auto park to recognize a potential parking space, and that the feature seems to have just disappeared about a year ago, meaning the parking icon never showed up to push no matter what they do. So this is a good and welcome development, of course. Many users asked questions about this, and other users said that the icon has always been there for them. Could it have something to do with having full self-driving purchased or enhanced autopilot features? If you have seen this correlation between FSD and autopilot, please specifically let me know in the comment section below, please. Another user states, saying the old ultrasonic version required something next to it to line up the entry, and say even so, if you were around empty spots, it will not pop up with auto park. You have to want to park next to someone else. That has been my experience, he says, and what I found online and from testing this at work. He says, the new vision only seems to work well based only on the lines. Now, I have the beta, used auto park on Friday and did use it before. I had the beta too. He says, it's all about setting up the car correctly. The vision system will correct this itself. Another user states that they use it almost every day, but the trick is to continue a little further than feels normal when hunting for the parking space. It takes about 2 seconds then for the little gray parking icon to appear. Another user said it can find spaces for parallel parking at a reasonable speed. Other parking bays need a reduced speed. Lastly, we saw another user still saying, I'm confident auto park on Tesla will work well as soon as full self-driving is at least level 3, maybe level 4, and is the consumer is also ready for that. They can't have it now because it won't it would cannibalize full self-driving sales. But when they have a future set to the difference differentiated to again, they'll offer it. Do you agree with this view? Because there is a huge gap between $0 and $10,000 for driver assist hands-on right now, but for Tesla. But they know the only sellable part of full self-driving now is enhanced autopilot. $100 subscription for it would be great too. Jeremy Johnson from Torque News Tesla reporting sim says, I think people would pay a couple thousand dollars for enhanced auto parking and not full self-driving. I don't know. I mean, I personally don't mind parking my car. I enjoy every aspect of driving. Jeremy says, here are his thoughts. He says, since I don't own a Tesla yet, I can't comment on the auto park icon being there or not for owners. What I can comment on is the usefulness of the feature. He says, I think a Tesla being able to park in a parking space is going to be one of the most important features it has. It may seem simple to just go park in a parking spaces, but I am thinking of the numerous and important applications that being able to park somewhere or go into a spot and stop will have for Tesla. He says, the first is being able to park after an autonomous taxi ride. In a video from Warren Redlich, where he rode in a Waymo self-driving vehicle, the vehicle drove awkwardly and stopped and dropped them off in the middle of the street. By the way, I will have the link of that video in the description of this video too, so you can watch it. This is no good and this is dangerous, says Jeremy. If Tesla can drop you off in a parking lot and not on the side of the street, that's a huge difference in safety and also, of course, user experience. The second important feature of auto park is for a Tesla going to park and go to a charger service stall. If a Tesla can park at a charger stall by itself and a service agent or some automatic system can open up the Tesla to charge it, then a Tesla could drive around autonomously without any need for intervention for thousands of miles before an owner would have to go do something to it, right? He says, maybe the owner would need to clean it regularly every day, depending on how people treat the car, but the cleaning could be done at a service center the car parks as well. So the your Tesla goes to a service center, parks itself, and the service center does the cleaning. The importance of being able to drive around to places and stop and charge, be cleaned or have service done means a car could operate for an owner autonomously without the owner ever needing to see the car. This is going to be one of the most amazing things to invest in. Imagine having a car make money for you and never seeing it. The third important feature, Jeremy says, of being able to auto park is that a Tesla can be conveniently delivered to you and wait for you to find it and get into it. I think in the future that someone would buy a Tesla will never have to go to a service center to pick up the vehicle. You see how many far-reaching implications auto park or features like this may have. So these people who buy Tesla, they will be able to just have the car drive to them and park in a safe place. So friends, let me know, what do you think of Tesla and its auto park feature? Is this an important feature? What would you use auto park for? Leave your comments, please, in the comment section below, and I'll look forward to reading them. What do you think about buying the Tesla, investing in it, and it making money for you and you never seeing it? Even you can probably program or schedule it, go to a service center for cleaning and goes to auto park itself, an automatic system opens it up and it charges itself and goes continues to ride sharing, some type of ride sharing thing that can still make money for you. How realistic do you think this is? I think this is realistic, maybe in the next within 5 to 10 years, depending on where we will reach level 5. 5. This will not work on level 4 autonomy, but needs level 5 autonomy in order to work. But still a very interesting concept that Jeremy Johnson discusses at torquenews.com. Please visit us at torquenews.com for daily several Tesla news that I don't get to report on our YouTube channel. This is Armin Harayan from torquenews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and discussions. I have two very interesting stories. One comparing Tesla's 4680 batteries with Toyota's upcoming solid-state batteries, and yet another story. To be honest, I made the script ready but forgot the topic, but I'll talk about that in next. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone, and peace be with you. See you soon in our next report.